Good afternoon. Thank you for watching Runaway Gaming. So we're going to be going over another round of Hearthstone. Let's see what we got this round. Now, Gilding's always a fun one, because that lets you go through the ranks pretty quickly. The quest can be a lot of fun. Bananas. So actually, I got a lot of good choices here. Probably a toss up between Gilding and Sire, because the quest can actually do quite a bit of fun stuff too. I might actually go with the safer route of trying to go high up in elementals if I can make it there. Murloc elemental bees, Naga and Undead. Oh, so they changed things. That's interesting, because before it was a little different. So, that's we probably want to gain 2 gold, because that'll get us over. Yeah, because that'll help us get to the rank 3 pretty quick. I think we probably do actually want to hold that. That's a lot of goodies. And ideally this triggers next round. And then once that triggers, that would give us the coin we need to hit tier 3 in this next round. Because then we'll go down to 6 and I'll have 5. And yeah, shouldn't be too bad of a round. Okay, so it actually straight down here instead. Let's return to Skyrim in another tier. I think that might be. Actually way better. Okay, so I just basically juggle through those over and over. That's actually not too bad. All right. So hopefully we find another Swamp Striker, and that is not the case. Yeah, so it looks like the big change they made with Galewing is you get three different locations. So one will give you the plus two, one will give you the two coins, and then the play land, which will give you a minion of the tier you're in. So, like, however, in order to do one you've previously went to, you basically have to complete one of the other ones first. So if I want to do this two coin one again, for example, I'll have to complete one of the other two first. So if you want to do money really quickly, you almost want to do 2-1, 2-1, 2. Since so far we're doing Murloc, think we might actually just not go up the rank right now. Now with Murloc, we do definitely want to get to 5 at the very least, because 5 will at least give us. Oh, sorry. We actually need 6 for a toxic one. The seafood guy is pretty good too, because you can just. So you don't have to look for 3 copies of things, you just golden things. And then, of course, Merkai is pretty good, because then you can just. If you manage to golden him, which is not hard to do with the seafood one, you can start triggering your. Enter the, battle cries. With your minion. So, like, if I golden this guy, which might come up pretty soon, so I may end up just selling these, but also, too, I need to try to get the brand, which I believe is in 5, because you want to make sure those trigger more often as well. But as of right now, we're just kind of scaling what we have on the battlefield now in hopes of at least not losing a bunch of health this round. So, yeah, I want to go up one. So I think we need a coin one more time. So we might do Westfall Iron Forge, and then at that point we'll do Eastern Plague Lands over and over again. Still nothing. So probably the 2 health guy. Then these three here will be eventually sold, probably. Or I hit 6 and just get the Murloc, and then he just keeps triggering like an upgraded version of that or an upgraded version of that. Actually, I might move him over to the end. Now that I think about man, as I said, it seems like just undead right now are significantly more powerful than a lot of the other factions. I mean, in some cases, you can still run away with, like, Murlocs, you can run away with elementals, but. I think some of the not as strong factions like dragons and pirates and stuff just don't have the same oomph, I guess. Yeah, just keep going up. So we'll do the two coin thing one more time. So when the two coin triggers, we'll. So next round we'll buy minions. And then on that second round, we'll probably upgrade one last time. Unless we get lucky and golden one of these. into a merc, which would be pretty good too, actually. That being said, too, I guess this guy wouldn't be too bad as far as kind of the Murloc way of playing as well. I guess it's a slightly better version of like the Swamp Strikers, really. But I guess the big thing though, Swamp Striker just hits the field much earlier, and because he hits the field much earlier, he can build up. So, well, that one's gonna hurt a little bit. So we want Bran, and I guess since we're playing against the guy that dropped early, that will be actually really good. Because now we can get a little bit greedy this round. More health stuff. This guy. Actually, that'll be good. I may not actually use him to gold on this right now, but basically, what I'm going to want to do is find one up here. So that way, when I pull him, he'll be golden, and then he can trigger the 6-star benefit one more time. I was hoping it'd be someone else. So normally this is where I might consider 6-starring. However, I think we actually do need to tempo a little bit, otherwise we might end up losing. And I really don't want to golden that. I know I passed one of them earlier, but start that either, to be honest. Hopefully, since this guy's in the mid range right now, hopefully it won't be too terribly bad. Still a fairly close one, though, which really isn't good. I don't like it much, but I think I'm just going to do it. And I guess I could have done that last time we went through this round too, but so things I know I'm going to be keeping on here for sure. Will probably be him at the very least. So let's trash that one. So that way he at least knocks out one thing immediately. I mean, he'd be another one I'm keeping, but he has enough power that it probably won't matter for now. I mean, later on I'll give him poisonous too, but. Brand's over getting some work done too. So I took him down at least. So at the very least, we're in the top four. We still do need to build up a little bit quicker. Let's clear that one up. And so basically, the big option here is either I can plus two everybody, which I believe would trigger twice, it'd be plus four to everyone, or plus four this guy five times, which can make those group pretty big, but. Let's prep next round real quick. We're gonna try and make it a little larger. That might be bigger though. the longer run of it. That's what I mentioned, Murlocs can certainly get there still. Like, oh, it's all bad. Actually, may not be a bad time. Two gold in that one. And I guess in this case, it really doesn't matter if I run this 5/5 or the 6/6. So I'm gonna toss him, throw 6/6 out there. Yeah, the good thing is now he'll buff both sides of it, so. I do want to golden this one too, because that'd be +4/+4, plus triggers twice. We tied it out. That's good. So he still got to get. Quite as exciting as I hoped. Poison. So poison should probably do. I know I'm keeping him too, and he doesn't have the strength to do a lot of damage yet. We'll save this one for this one. It'd be pretty good to get. Estimates, we're probably gonna lose this one. We'll see how it pans out, but. would take a little bit of damage there, which is still fine. It's not ideal, but so I may not actually go 3 rounds. We're gonna be optimistic. Because if we tie with them. Switch that around, switch that around. Because last few times the one guy comes down and basically swipes both. So put him on the end. Actually, let's spread. Yeah, we'll keep it together. Because it'll probably come down and swipe the center. What if I put him on the outside? At least it increased our odds of winning when we do that minor little switch. And unfortunately, that's game. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching Randomly Gaming. You have a good day.